one lady says to her neighbor, every day I give $5 to a lazy bum. The neighbor asks, your husband doesn't say anything about it? No, he tells thank you. So it's too much. But it's okay. Here is a sharing from Calgary. Clarissa Wagner, Calgary. Clarissa, I was taught early on that money would bring happiness and that in order to show others love, you had to buy them lots of presents on holidays. And the more money you spent showed how much you loved them. Even if you had to spend money you did not have. I am learning how to practice Reiki and also do some metaphysical healing. But I do not want to charge people. I feel wrong about it, that I have to charge people to help them. I have spent a lot of money to take my training and I am worried that the money will not come back to me, especially if I cannot get over the idea that I do not want to charge them. Clarissa, first thing, Clarissa, Calgary. Where is Calgary? Yes. Clarissa, first thing, if you are confident enough about the product you are offering, any healing you are giving, any service you are giving, I will sincerely recommend you go for charging. The guilt that you are not supposed to charge is a wrong idea. You are offering your time, and the service you are offering is a honest service, then you don't need to be guilty about charging money at all. Forget about this guilt and straight away take money. It is nothing wrong. Another thing, especially like a services like a healing and all, if you take little money from them, they will have more trust on your healing. I have seen in my life, when I was giving free classes and free healing, nobody was respecting. They thought I don't have confidence on the product I am offering. Now you see, the moment I started charging, the amount of respect I am receiving. You see, earlier I am using only 45 rupee chappal. That chappals which I am wearing are 45 rupee plastic rubber chappal. Earlier with that rubber chappal I used to sit and ask for 1,000 rupee for Pada Puja and healing. Not a single fellow is ready to pay and they were talking all nonsense. I just created a golden chappal and now 28,000 rupee I am charging. Simply people are coming and doing the Pada Puja. But in my personal life I am wearing only 45 rupee chappal. When I walk I wear only that. This is the life. Talk to people in their language. I learnt it. I am teaching you. Come on. No, really. You see, earlier people are not ready to give 1,000 rupee to wash the plastic chappal, rubber chappal. Now they are ready to pour 25,000 rupee to wash the golden chappal. Anyhow, both I am not. Now golden chappal is there, but I don't put my feet at all in that. If you have seen Pada Puja, you will see. I will not be even putting my feet on that. I put my foot only on the plastic chappal, rubber chappal. I continue my life. But this is for public. Because you are not happy. Oh, what is this plastic chappal, rubber chappal? I have to wash paying 1,000 rupee. But you are very happy when you need to wash the golden chappal with 25,000 rupee. Great. That is the language you understand. Come on, let me speak that language to you. It is the confidence you have on the product you are offering. That's all, nothing else. So I'll sincerely recommend you to charge. And they'll also have trust over you. here is one more question from Vancouver. Can engram be created in the muscle memories before birth? When my mom was pregnant of me, my parents were building their farm and were going through stress and worry on how to get the money to pay for the new infrastructure and support the family. Pauline, usually this kind of engrams doesn't get built during the pregnancy. Only the deeper concepts like a spiritual engrams gets built during pregnancy. The money engrams doesn't get built during pregnancy. Don't worry about it. This is a message from Vaidehi, Toronto. Problem, I can't relate to money. I don't have clear understanding about money. I go to work, earn a decent salary and spend it all within a week. I have been doing this unconsciously ever since I came into contact with the green bills. I hope you could help me realize the value and proper use so that I don't remain in the poverty line. Understand? These green bills are a big problem. And the credit card is a bigger problem. At least in the green bills, you know how many bills are leaving you. In the credit card, you don't even know. It's just swiping. Whether 900 has gone or 9000 has gone, you don't even know. Because same, once the swiping, that's it. Tomorrow when I am talking about this sustenance, priorities, I'll handle this subject. Wealth money won't bring you fulfillment. Kamala Lochana, Vancouver. Vancouver. Kamala Lochana. Understand, wealth does not bring you fulfillment ultimately. True. That does not mean remaining poor brings you fulfillment. Come on. Remaining poor, see. The other day we were all discussing with brahmacharis and I became enlightened without getting the regular education. That does not mean all the fellows who are uneducated are going to become enlightened. Same way, wealth does not bring ultimate fulfillment. That is true. That does not mean all poor fellows are going to have ultimate fulfillment. Wealth and poverty both are equally not going to bring you ultimate fulfillment. So ultimate fulfillment is different line altogether. No way you being wealthy or poor is going to interfere, stop or prepone or postpone your enlightenment. Then why don't you be wealthy? Your wealth is neither going to postpone nor going to prepone your enlightenment. So that is totally different direction. San Jose, sometimes I regret money I have spent. Why? Why is everyone asking everyone else's money, family to invest money? The problem is, in India, your money is not your money. It is your friend's money. It is your family's money. It is all the poor relatives around you, their money. All of them think they have share over your money. And no, really. All of them think they have share over your money. Especially if you are living in America, all Indians think. In America, all over the road, dollar bills are running, floating and flying. You just need to go there and have few gunny bags, just dump everything and send it in the ship to India. Come on. You come to reality and teach all your relatives about reality. Your money is your money. My money is my money. You are having money because you worked for it. I am not saying don't be compassionate, don't be charitable. But be very clear. Only when you are very clear, you are not going to repent for it, be charitable. If you feel you may repent in future, don't be charitable. Be very clear. Charity should not come with guilt. Then you will be stuck with it. Understand? The moment you start counting what all you gave, you lost all the merit and punya of giving. For example, if you have given some money for some your friend or a family or a temple or a school or ashram for something, even once if you count, I have given all these things, over, all your punya is gone. You chine punye madhya logam vishanti. Come back to ordinary world. All your merit has gone. Your token for heaven is taken away. Now, no more heaven. Get back to your regular life. So anything makes you count. It is the question from Lokesh, San Jose. So if you are repenting, don't give. Be very clear. If you are regretting, don't give. Just see that you are making them understand your money is your money and their money is their money. Here is a question from Puram Sharma. I was raised with a strict saving and conservative habits. So I believe it should be taught to my kids, and it is my big responsibility. I am confused and afraid. If I let my kids spend openly, they will learn wrong habits. Please guide me. Is controlling okay or letting go? Please understand. You should teach them saving habits, but you should teach them creating habits. Creation of wealth. Creation and saving is okay. Just saving, I think you will destroy them. So teach them the habit of creation also. And here is from New York. Money is root of all evil, and also money is freedom. Here is the conflict. Also, money causes people to become ugly, greedy, and cause unhappiness in others, and money is control. Also, another click is talking myself out of making money, as money only comes to those lucky. You can kill yourself working and not make money. I have seen this with my parents. This flows into it is not possible to create wealth out of your creativity and enjoyment, only boring work. Samarpini, no. There are many wrong understandings in this. New York. There is New York. Samarpini, yes. All right. First thing, there is no such thing as luck. Luck is negligible percent. It gets popular. Does not mean it is common. You see, receiving salary only is common. Receiving lottery is rare. Only 0.01% of the population receive lottery in their life. 99.99% of the people receive only salary in their life. So understand that 0.001% people who receive lottery becomes very popular all over the world because it is rare, not because it is regular. See, regular things becoming popular and rare things becoming popular, you need to understand. Lottery is a rare thing becoming popular, not regular thing becoming popular. So, don't expect luck to add wealth to you. That is not going to happen. So, have a clear system to add wealth to you. Waiting for luck to happen, for wealth to happen in your life, is wasting your life. No, that is not the right mental setup. This is Vaishali from San Jose. Swamiji, you said that never think this is enough. Keep on creating. My question is, if we spend our entire day and life creating wealth, which I know at back of my mind that it is not real, it is just Maya, it is not going to go with me when I leave the world, When will I take time off from this mental setup of creating wealth and focus on Brahman, which is real? Vaishali, I wanted to ask you, what do you know about Brahman? Come on, relax. There is, you don't need a separate time to put your mind on Brahman. Create wealth intensely. Know that it is Maya. You are not going to carry it when you leave the body. You are already in Brahman. Create wealth intensely, knowing you are not going to carry it when you die. You are in Brahman. There is no other separate Brahman. You need to sit and catch and jump on him. Relax. Vaishali, I think you understand what I am saying. Where is Vaishali? Okay, great. Please be seated. You don't need separate time for you to take your mind away from Maya and soak it in Brahman and take it out and wash it again and soak it in Brahman again. Relax. People have become too big Vedantis. Now I am seeing in this whole crowd, except me, everybody is a Paramahamsa. Only I am very down to earth and practical and real. Everybody is giving all Vedantic teachings to me. Come on. Give me a break.